So I'm Nikos Minadakis. I'm a research and development engineer in FORTH, and I'm mostly working now with designing and developing infrastructures that have to do about research and that are based on semantic web technologies. I started actually, the first project that I was involved was Life Goes Greece. That was a semantic-based infrastructure for keeping data about the biodiversity and the occurrences of species in Europe. And now I'm working on a VRE4EIC project, which is about creating VREs. And again, it is about assisting the researchers with their works, with their work. And I was also working in a Bluebridge project that we created a global record of stocks and fisheries for the FAO of the United Nations, and it was also based in semantic web technologies. There are a lot of tools that you need to use. So you start from tools about extracting the data from the various sources. Then you have to map this data and therefore their format with your semantic model's format. Yeah. After the mapping, you have to transform this data to the format that you have as the underlying backbone of the infrastructure, let's say. And then you also want tools to be able to query this data. Yeah. And sometimes you may need some data cleaning and normalization tools also. Of course, the process now that you will follow in order to select these tools has to do with the requirements of each project. Regarding the size of the data sets that you are going, let's say, to store in your infrastructure, you start with selecting the appropriate trip store. So if you are going to use inference, then you need a tripstore that supports it. If you expect a lot of data that requires online updating, then you need to select tripstores that do not take a lot of time to store the data or to load this data. And also you have to take in mind if the community of the tripstore is active, because it's obvious that you will find some issues and you will have to solve them, etc. So this is regarding the tripstores. Now regarding the tools that are making the mappings, then I think that the most important thing is that they should be user-friendly and that they should be easily used by people that are not IT experts, because these projects are interdisciplinary. They are using scientists from various fields, like biologists, archaeologists, etc., that they cannot use, obviously, IT tools, or they cannot code. So you need something that is very easy for them to be used. Actually, here in FORTH, we've implemented a language that is called XML. This is a declarative language for defining mappings between source data and formats, and between the target data and format. And then we have implemented 3M Editor, which is a graphical user interface that allows users that are not experts to define their mappings by using a user-friendly, let's say, user interface. It's not obviously the simplest thing in the world, but we have proven that it's something that works. We also have the XML engine, which is a tool that realizes the transformation of the data from the source format to the target format based on the mappings that have been defined in the 3M editor that I said before. Now, regarding the tripstores, we are working mostly with BlazeGraph and Virtuoso. The most common issue that I've seen is that there is not a distinction between the definition of the mapping and the creation of the URIs. So if this is not distinguished, then you cannot have the experts do their job, which is the mappings, and then the IT personnel to do their jobs, which is the URI definition and creation. And I think that most of the tools, if not all of the tools, do not do this, except XML engine that I mentioned earlier. Okay, obviously you have to do a research and to find something else that may have a more active community, or that it will fulfill your new requirements. Of course, we try to follow a modular approach, so you have distinct components, but simple components that are used in a bigger workflow, so it is easy to replace one component with a newer one. But if we are not able to find something, then we have to develop it from scratch.